You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download.
Welcome to Class 2, Setting Up the Paint Project. My name is Katie Morris and I will be your instructor. In this class, I will talk about the nature of paint tasks, shot approach, how to denoise your footage for the paint task, explore the paint node including its brushes and tools, and lastly, run through the brush profile tab. Let's get started. Here's a collage of the paint shots that I will be demoing in this course. Paint tasks, or sometimes referred to as paint prep, can include dirt removal, marker removal on blue screens or green screens, humans and objects, wire removal, beauty paint, paint animation, plate reconstruction, and more. Paint prep tasks can also require a certain degree of compositing. So why is it important to learn and master paint methodologies, both manual and procedural? It's because some paint tasks can't be tackled with traditional compositing methods. Each shot in each class will start with a shot approach plan, and I have made a slide with some talking points. While one might just want to dive in and start working, it's really important to take the time and execute shot work properly. Clarify task, shot length, handles. We've all been there, turning in a shot with the wrong length. It's good to double check if there would be any retiming as well. Check in with upstream and downstream artist teams. Is there roto that has already been done that you can use to help with your shot? As the compositor run a take, that will be helpful to understand the scope of the work required. Do you have to clean or fix the entire plate? And next is confirm denoise regrain protocol. It's become standard practice to paint on denoise plates, but what about regraining? Is that a step that you need to take care of? Next, deadline communication updates. Always check what the deadlines are and make sure you communicate on a regular basis. Next, play back the shot over and over to analyze. I must play back a shot around 20 times before I get ideas on how to approach the work. I also look to see if there are cameras, geometry, or match moves available that I can use. Next, determine plan of action, manual or procedural techniques, or both. I always try to start with a procedural technique, but recognize when manual painting will be better fit. Most of the time, I use a combination. Next, QC delivery with appropriate alpha channel embedded if required. Always QC your work before handing it off. No chattering paint, no ghosting in your paint, no bad pixels. The tracking is solid, edges match the quality of the original plate, no overly blurry or sharp areas, and if required, the embedded alpha matches the areas you worked on. And lastly, tidy up work files. It's so easy to complete a shot and call it done, thinking it will never come back. But they do, so it's best practice to keep your files, scripts, project organized, and labeled internally where possible. You will thank yourself if you have to revisit it. So now let's take a look at our first shot. It's a clip with two wingsuit flyers. I already have a session set up for denoising, as you can see here. But the shot approach step can be done here too, as well. So let's play back the shot. For the paint task here, I need to remove the camera on the front of the female wingsuit flyer and also the helicopter. So my thoughts are the camera will be a manual paint task. As I zoom in and take a closer look and scrub through, just the plus button here, I can see that every frame is a bit different, so a tracked patch would not work in this area. Or it's possible that one could use several small tracked patches for different ranges, but that could result in a lot of time bridging them all together. For the camera over the sky, that can be done quickly with frame-by-frame paint and offsets. However, if I press F and frame the shot in the viewer, it looks like the helicopter could be painted out with auto paint with some manual paint touch-ups. It's also possible that a patch could be used for that area, but skies are tricky as there's always some gradient with lighting that changes and might prove time-consuming to match the original plate. So if I track the helicopter, then use auto paint and clone from areas next to the helicopter on each frame, then there's a chance that the lighting and gradient will match. Before I start the denoising process, I'm going to add a note to my trees window. I'm going to go down to the nodes group here. I'm going to find the note. drag it up here. And now I'm going to put some information in here about the shot. Let me just move things around a little bit more. So this is the note node, and to add text to the note node, you have to click on the letters here, and then I'm going to choose a larger font, and I'm going to put in the frame range that I need to work on and what needs to be done. Remove camera on female wingsuit flyer and remove the helicopter. That way it's clear and I'm ready to move on. So now it's time to denoise our clip. Denoising is an essential but unglamorous step. Fortunately, this type of task has become monumentally easier with the introduction of modern denoising tools. Silhouette has a new node called DenoiserML, which employs sophisticated deep learning techniques to eliminate unwanted noise from images while preserving critical features. So let's bring in that node right now. I'm selected on the source. I'm going to click Tab and start typing denoise. And it's right there. I'm just going to hit Return and wait for the node to be placed in my tree. And it's common for it to take a little bit of time. Okay, now we're all set. So inside the DenoiserML node, I typically don't change any of the parameters. I just leave it at camera noise v2.1 and the amount at 100%. So let's do a little comparing. If I zoom in here, and if I click on our source node here, and I click snapshot, and then I go down to denoise and I click the vertical split, you can see now I have my denoised image on the right. It's a little bit hard to see maybe when I'm recording, so I'll just see if I can see a little bit better with different channels. Alt B, you can see the grain on the left. Alt G, Alt R, and back to color. So I think this looks good. We still have a lot of detail and the grain is removed. So now I just have to make sure that my output node is hooked up correctly and is filled out so that it will render to the correct location with the correct name. And I've already done that here. And we'll just click on this three dots here to browse to make sure that's going to the correct location. It's going to my D and footage folder. And my naming looks correct down here in the sample box. So now all I have to do is render, but I've already rendered the denoise and I brought it back into my project. So now we are ready for the next part of the class.